Okay, back at it. We have a queen worm to smash. Thinking I might need to do this. That does put David in a bit of danger. I know. Oh. Well. And that's it for the worm. Stationary. That is good. Let's see, does anyone down here need healing? Not really. Okay. Let's just go this way. Don't want to get head for kill straight away. Okay, that harpy moved in a very different direction than I was expecting. Which, on the whole, is a good thing. Oh, now you've come alive. Just move him over here and then bring him in when I have more people ready to launch attacks. Let's see, get your auras right. Whatever, the important thing is that Medion is healed. And he will be. He'll be healed to full without the, without using as much MP as a heal level 3 would use. Emperor. Wrong direction. You just made the wrong choice, dude. God damn this. Well. Oh, screw it. Let's just hold on to hope. Hope that Dolorik will hold his own long enough against the Hell Sniper, but he will not be murdered before I get to murder the boss. And David goes totally ham on the priest. That is fine. And the mage doesn't do a thing. I like that. I like that in a mage. Unless they are in my party. Yeah. That worm can move very far. So that's all right. Duel of the archers. Or snipers. Bernard is suddenly not looking like the clear wiener here. Let's see. Jade. We need to take care of the harpy, first and foremost. Good enough. Huh. Seriously, is this Shining Force gameplay? Yeah, the other Shining Force games, they just didn't do this. You did not get one-hit kills there. Well, I mean, not for damage anyway. Okay. That is unfortunate, but Jade is still alive. And I'm trying to send a Ryudo to heal up Bernard. It's not going too well. Good grief, man. No, I think we can pull Jade back and have him be healed up by someone else. The poison shouldn't deal too much damage to prevent that. To get him killed before that happens. Okay, Bernard should have this in the bag. Or should I? Yeah, let's have a Tornado 3. Just for the fun of it. Damage. Just had to check. 64 against 1. Yeah. She might not actually have dealt that much damage with a normal physical attack. I made the right choice there. I feel good about myself. You can do this. This is good. I don't quite understand why she should level up attack by 2. Well, I mean, gain attack boost of 2 every turn, every time she levels up. She's not going to be an attacker. That's, you know, that is something that we know for sure. Observable fact, I guess you would call it if you could word properly. Oh, okay, Bernard's still alive. Okay, let's... well... 11 damage is a lot, but he's still alive. Maybe I'll just stand over here, yeah? have one of those, but I'm gonna drop the queen. That should be it for the sniper. Oh yeah, now you do a dirty owl. Should do that. Just in case no one gets around to detoxing him. And with my luck, Synthesis will have an antidote on her. Huh, okay, she doesn't. Good. Or whatever. I can kill you with him, alright? Well, with Sephiris at least, not with a normal freeze, level 2. Now, just in case someone didn't notice this before, the different spellcasters can have, different attack strength with different magic types. That kind of came to a head with, I think it was Noon, who couldn't cast Spark for, well, shit, really. While Symbiose, of all people, dealt somewhere in the neighborhood of 30 points of damage with one attack. Noon maybe did, 10, 17, that area. Now, Medion, I will pull back ever so slightly. Go ahead, good sir. And try to level up. Woo, 10 points of damage. Weehee. Didn't see this one coming, did ya? Okay. Jesus. I'm just too good. I'm too good for this game. Jade. You were indeed not cured. If I put you there, you'll be in range of Ryudo. That will have to suffice. I could have titled this episode Worm Tactics, actually. I decided not to. Be grateful, okay? let's see... Yeah. Oh! Oh, right. I just realized that was actually pretty stupid of me. Well, hindsight's 20/20, I say. Yeah. Precisely. Well, Well, this level 3 isn't so bad. We can take this. Just to give Hera something to do and a bit of experience. Oh, like I guess Hera, well, Hera should have possibly healed me instead, but. Well, this will be the end of that. The baby dragon and its mother are both in the cave. Dragon will destroy you. You will not make it out of the volcano. Even if by some chance you do, Aspia will have strengthened its defenses by then. Leon, Dominic, you will be stopped soon enough. Boom. Poof. Away you go. This is another trap for us. There's no time for preparations. We must get to Aspia. Prince Arant and the Bolton forces have slowed our progress a great deal. If our goal is Aspia, then the encounters to come will be much more difficult. Very true, Grantak. It would be unwise to rush in against a prepared enemy. The Emperor has given you a choice, Prince Medion. If you feel it necessary, we can return to Swampland to prepare before continuing on to Aspia. So, Medion, for someone who has never supported war, that cave leads to the destiny of Aspia and Dystonia. There is, and never has been, any turning back. If you don't support this invasion, Prince Medion, now is the time to let your feelings be known. So, we are going to, enter this fight regardless of my needs, okay? Good to feel wanted, I guess. Although I will cast return and revive people because I do need a flyer, I think. Pretty sure. So now we have a gimmick. Parts of the map will rise and fall, like you see there, slightly left of center. Good baby dragon, get angry, make the path floating in the magma difficult for them to cross. Dun dun dun. Heh, you seem surprised. Isn't the rising and falling of the path in the magma delightful? I wouldn't say delightful, no. The dragon is shaking with rage. He thinks you came here to kill him. We may have dropped a few hints to that effect. How do you drop hints to a dragon, exactly? Neither the Bolzom sect nor Prince Arant wants you to pass through this cave. If you try to force your way through, you will die. Whether you defeat the dragon or not, you will sink into the magma. I see. How troublesome. The volcano seems to be becoming less stable. There's a possibility that the terrain will separate our forces. How do you intend to handle this, Medion? This shall not even be a challenge for the Prince Emperor. Not allowing one's troops to be divided is one of the most basic leadership principles. There is no need to be concerned about the Prince's ability. A reliable Mayfederate. I'm counting on you, Medion. Do not betray my confidence. Yeah, general hard ass. Come on, game. Load up the fight. Okay, so let's see. What do we have? What do we have? That is where we are supposed to exit. I think. Or could be here. We have a number of new enemies, and we have a number of enemies, period. Let's see, these Bloodborns, we met these in Scenario 1, but they seem to have slightly higher stats. Now this one is first in Scenario 2. Minotaur. Seems to be about the same as in the latter stages of Scenario 1. You're nothing new, and you are just what we fought in the previous fight. Huh. That's interesting. We have two exits. Well, either way, wow. I don't know if you can tell, but yeah, the frame rate is dropping here. yeah, the console is having a problem drawing all this. Oh! I totally forgot I could do that. Yeah. Thanatos level 2? We are going to be having some fun with that. But now... take back 0. And we might as well save over here. Give that protect ring back to... Well, I say back, but, you know. You can give this to Synthesis. Great. All good. Where are the shops again? I need me some shops. Oh, right, here they are. Let's see, anything to sell, really, but we can repair that thing, we should do that. Hey, I meant to keep talking to you. I have to check if this is any... No, it isn't really. Okay. Gale Lance. That does give Cavalry a considerable boost. If I intend to use him, but I will need him for the Hero's Test Dungeon at the end of the game. I will really need him for the end of the game. Let's see, do I buy it now? No, I think I should save my money. We have another blacksmith coming up. No, you still have that. Okay, so now Bernard is overpowered as F again. You won't need that. And yeah. Now we're good. Okay, back to the cave, I guess. See, there's nothing we've forgotten, right? No, I don't think so. Okay, let's just go. Gonna see a whole lot of this next fight before I end the episode, but we can get our feet wet. That'll be good fun. Let's see, we need to go this way and then up there. Okay. Now the key to this fight is sticking together. Just outside of reach. Camelot, I bet you did that on purpose. Oh wait, haha. Okay, there you go, there's a harpy out there. We try to stick together. Now, as I recall, the exit we need to go through is the one that is on the left side of the map, as the screen is oriented now. Not the one on the south. Let's see, you can't attack from there, can you? No, that's actually good. Yeah, you guys keep thinking about what you're gonna do. Okay, at the end of each turn, the area will, the elevations will toggle. Like so. So what you need to do is, of course, to keep track of which bits of the map move, which don't, and try to move your entire force onto the moving tiles when the when the need arises, when you are at the places that move around, like. Okay, I will put you there, actually. I don't think elevation factors into the damage calculation in this game, but if that is inaccurate, do say so. I will take any correction. So, I wonder how badly Arthur is going to get owned on the next phase. Or throughout this turn, I mean. Let's see. So, 36. Need 50 to kill the thing. So he might score crit, but then he would be dead as dirt. I will hold him back. Well, nice knowing you, Arthur. At least he did get that new special attack. Another 10 minutes. See, oh. Well. What to do about that? Okay, 25 points. I think they have some fire resistance, so blaze is not going to be a good thing. Try spark. I'll do that. Lots of damage, but no kill. Huh. Zero could take care of that business. I will go balls out and hope that he does indeed manage it. Well, put him here in some... Well, lot of danger. Plenty of danger. Zero. Whenever you're ready. Zero. Almost a bit of consolation prize thing going on there. Okay. He sucks a little less. Good one. Oh. Hell sniper. Let's keep Zero away from that guy. Sniper. Yeah, who was to bet that I will completely forget about him when I move Zero around? Okay, so on the next turn we smash those two Hydras and the Harpy. Then we should be able to move on to the moving thingamajig. Pro strats. Come on, Thanatos. No. Oh well. Here. Oh yeah. Burn our power! Why do you have to do this when you have full HP? Seriously. Okay. That's what you want to fight for us. Counter, please. Nope. But such low damage intake is good. Right, there's that hell sniper. Wow. Dude, I totally lucked out there. I'll just put zero there then. We should not put him anywhere near that hell sniper, of course. That is priority one. I want him to level up normally. I don't want to have to send him to the hero's test and do the whatever. I will have to end the episode soon. Let's see, can I leave the harpy to zero? Yes, I very much can. Okay. So, come at me, bros. Yeah, there's another one I could leave to zero. I want to. Could be safer, honestly. Harpies can be dodgy. Bernard, well, you really didn't have to do all that. Right? Oh yes. Go media. Now Zero will be pretty close to that hell sniper, yes. But yeah. I think between Medion and David, that hell sniper should be pretty short work. Good, we get Hasuki with us as well. Should I have healed her, perhaps? Yeah, possibly. Oh well. No, you couldn't reach the sniper anyway. Fine. Thank you. And yeah, the riveting continuation of this fight will be in the next episode. See you then, everyone. Ah, it's so hard to stop playing this game.